I'm Chris from Emporia Energy, and today we'll be installing the Emporia Vue Energy Monitor in a residential breaker panel. Before I get started, we do recommend that this installation be conducted by a qualified professional for a safe installation. Here's what you're going to need to install the Vue Monitor. A mobile device running iOS or Android, a Phillips head screwdriver, flathead screwdrivers, both large and small, wire strippers and cutter, a voltage tester of some kind, a alternative light source for when you turn off the breaker in the panel, you may lose light in the area that you're working, and a pair of gloves. Inside the box, you'll find the Emporia Vue Gateway module, the Wi-Fi antenna, two different kinds of current transformers or CTs, two or three of the 200 amp CTs for the mains lines, and 8 or 16 50 amp CTs for the branch circuit lines, a wiring harness to power the Vue device itself, a couple of wires and wire nuts to tap into the breakers to power the Vue device, a set of labels to label the circuits if they aren't already, and a getting started card with a QR code and a link to the Emporia app, which will manage the Vue device as well as contains all of the instruction manuals for installing the device. The first step is to turn off power and all of your breakers. Make sure you have an alternate light source if you're going to lose light in the area you're in. The second step is to remove the cover of the panel to access the wiring to the breakers. Make sure that you're safe by testing the power coming out of your breakers and the mains breaker to make sure none of it is live. The next step is to place the Emporia Vue monitor in the panel box. In this case, there's a lot of room in the bottom right, so that's where I'll be placing it in this panel box, but it can go anywhere that it fits in the box. If you'd like a different way of mounting it, you can use double-sided Velcro or a DIN mount kit, which you can call us for, to mount it anywhere on a DIN rail in the box. The next step is to install the Wi-Fi antenna that's going to connect to the Vue. In this case, I'm going to knock out the rear knockout at the bottom of this panel and mount the antenna down inside the wall. The antenna does need to be mounted outside of the box for the proper signal integrity. These current transformers are a clamshell type. They have a little clip where they open and they just clip around the wire that you want to measure. It's important to note that these current transformers have a label on the back of each one with an arrow pointing to breaker. And they need to be installed so that arrow is pointing at the breaker. Otherwise, the current that they are measuring will be registered as negative and will come up as negative in the app. The 50 amp current transformers also have an arrow pointing towards the breaker. They need to be installed that way in the branch circuits as well. One thing to note is that if a breaker or a circuit uses both phases of the split phase power, so 240 volts, you only need to use one current transformer on one pole of that circuit, and then it can be doubled in the application to get the correct amperage. In the case where you have a panel that just uses bus bars or doesn't have enough room for the CT sensors, we offer as accessories on our website these flex sensor CTs that can fit in situations where these white sensors may not. Next, I'm going to install the wiring harness that will power the Vue itself. This wiring harness needs to be powered from the power to the breakers themselves. So they need to be tapped into the breakers. In this case, I have one open breaker spot on this bottom breaker, but on the other connection I'm going to need to make, I'm going to need to wire tap in with the included wire and wire nuts to create a connection to that circuit for this power harness. The wiring harness has four wires on it, black, blue, red, and a white. The white is always neutral and we will be connected to the neutral bus bar or ground in the panel. The black, blue, and red are for the three phases of power, if you have three phase power, or the black and the red are for the two phases of split phase power. In the case of this panel, I have split phase power, so I'm going to connect the black to one phase of the main, the red to the other phase of the main, and just connect this blue to the ground bus with, along with the white neutral cable, because we don't have a third phase of power. With all the CTs hooked up now, we're ready to connect the CTs to the Vue gateway unit itself. One thing to note is that now that the CTs are in place, if you'd like to keep your cables managed and clean inside of the panel box, you can cut the lines as long as they needed to be and remove the screw terminal connectors from each CT to the shortened line, and you can manage your cables nicely. Now that everything's in place and the unit is connected, it's time to power it on and make sure we connected it correctly. The way I'm gonna do that is first turn on the mains power, and then I'm gonna turn on the breaker to which the power connections for the Vue are connected. I should see the LED on the Vue turn on, and that's how we know we've connected it correctly. The Vue is powered up, it's time to turn on all the other breakers. Now that we have the Vue installed and the panel all buttoned up, it's time to onboard the Vue in the Emporia app. If you have any questions throughout any of this process, please feel free to reach out to support@emporiaenergy.com to contact our customer support, or contact them directly through the Emporia application.